No, my first name ain't baby. Nasty boy.
What's up, Toilet Ducks? I had so much fun covering Mormo last week. It's fun to shit on shitty shit, but sometimes it's fun to share awesome things. And today, I'm gonna keep that theme going. We're gonna cover one singer. The last time there was an episode about one singer, that was episode 34, Jan Terry. Exactly twice that many episodes later, here we are at episode 68, and today we cover one singer. In the mid to late 80s, there was one girl who had dreams to be the next big thing, and it might have happened if not for the simple fact that she cannot sing well. For the simple fact that she cannot sing
at all.
But hey, her passion is through the roof. Meet Sondra Prill. Welcome, listener. This is
The Internet is the Toilet.
Sondra Prill was strictly a cover singer. These days, through online streaming, people can become famous for singing cover songs. But this was the 80s. No precious YouTube yet. Sondra went for the next best thing and started her own public access show with the innovative title, My Show. It ran from 1987 to 1992 and featured her homemade videos as well as in-studio performances. She was also given the honor of performing Channel 12 station sign-off by singing the Star Spangled Banner in front of a green screen, hugging herself and pretending to move in slow motion.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light?
And before you say anything about the singing, this is easily her best performance. We're gonna ease into Sondra.
Ooh, stripes and bright stars, the bombs burst in air.
So yeah. Not good, and definitely her best, by far. Along with having her own show and the sign-off, she would also appear on other shows that aired on the same public access station.
We're gonna hear Sandra now sing.
Oh, okay.
14 seconds of dead air later.
Running hot, running cold. I wasn't running into all alone. It was
It's not easy to sing so off-key. This takes talent.
I took it so high, so low. So low, there was nowhere to go like a bad dream.
Oof. Some of these notes are brutal. I would like to apologize to all of the dog owners out there.
I'm in control, my worries are few. Cause I got another guy I never knew.
And this was a live performance on the show It's Casual. Luckily for us, It's Casual aired live.
I got a call.
Okay.
Hi, It's Casual. You're on the air.
Yes, I just have a comment regarding the young lady that just sang.
If it's not nice, honey, I'm gonna hang up.
Oh, it's very nice.
Oh, well, thank you.
I just really have to say that she has a big set of balls.
I told you, if you can't say it's nice, don't you call me, because I'm a Roy's mother.
But on to Sondra's very own public access show, My Show. As far as public access goes, the set is almost predictable. Fake plants, a plain wood trellis. It ran on and off for 5 years. And here's my favorite part. There were three episodes. Three! Having hosted a public access show of my own, I know this. You can send them the same tape every month. They'll literally play anything you send. I've heard racial slurs and seen titties on Rhode Island public access alone. But yeah, three episodes. In episode one, Sondra did a country duet with her friend Dave Turner. They sang the Kenny Rogers Dolly Parton classic, Islands in the Stream, and holy shit, it's beautiful.
Would you do something to me that I can't?
these one-part harmonies breathtaking?
Hold me closer and I feel no pain in every beat of my heart. We got something going on.
Oh, here comes the chorus. Rumor has it they actually try to harmonize.
Islands in the stream, that is what we are. No one in between, how can we be wrong?
This poor guy. It has to be hard to stay in tune while trying to sing along with a dying flamingo. She never really hits any note. She's just trying to find it the whole time. But her performance is fantastic. Her eyes, her gestures. When they sang the line, "No one in between," she was flailing her arm in between the two of them to prove that there was no one in between. Fucking genius. Also in episode 1 was a low-budget, self-produced music video of Robert Palmer's Addicted to Love, and this one has a storyline. Kind of. I can't explain it. You have to see it. She gives the craziest crazy eyes I've ever seen, but enough with the attempts at trying to explain the fucking visuals. The audio is just as odd. The mix. Her performance. What the fuck?
The lights are on, but you're not home, and your mind is not your own. Your heart sweats, your body shakes.
It's giving me weird Halloween vibes. I wonder when this episode aired. Oh, probably from late 1988 to early 1991.
Another kiss is all you need.
To even have the slightest morsel of Sondra's lack of self-awareness would be a good thing for all of us. Side rant, but there's fucking too many people out there trying to make shitty shit on purpose, and it discredits the genuine ones like fucking Sondra. I frequent the subreddit Crappy Music, and a lot of people post their own new music there. You know, I would get it if it was something you made a long time ago and you could want to laugh at it, but when you're making new music, people should aim fucking higher than crappy. Save that shit for people like Sondra. Moving on to episode 2, I give you the greatest version of Janet Jackson's Nasty.
Now a song for all you nasty boys.
Give me a beat!
You have to see this video too. It's Sondra and all of her attitude rocking a fur coat on stage with a couple of male strippers. The original version of this song is supposed to give off that whole sexy naughty vibe. Well, in Sondra's version, she comes off as legitimately pissed off.
Sitting in the movie show, thinking that their thoughts suck. A bathtub of gentlemen only turned me off. Ha! That's right, let me tell you, nasty boys don't mean a thing. Ha!
I could play this whole thing. I might, but I won't. Maybe.
Nasty boys, let me see your nasty body move. Oh, you nasty boys. No, my first name ain't baby. Nasty boys.
All right, that's all I'm playing from this absolute masterpiece.
Nasty!
Don't mean a thing.
Okay, for real now, that's it. One of the stripper dudes in this video, at one point, starts rubbing his junk on the hand railing of a dance cage. Nasty indeed! Hoof! But moving on to another song that we all know and love.
Pump up the jam, pump it up, while your feet are thumping, and the jam is pumping, look ahead, the crowd is jumping. Pump it up a little more, get the party going on the beach shore. See, cause that's where the party's at, and you'll find out if you do that.
You heard what I just heard, but let me tell you what I'm looking at. She's on the beach, switching between wearing a massive black fur coat and a beaded little onesie, kicking sand in the faces of unsuspecting beachgoers while she yells at them like a fucking drill sergeant. At one point, she seamlessly transitions from pissed off drill sergeant to cute little Sondra in a matter of three words. It's amazing.
Pump it up a little more. Get the party going on the beach shore. See, cause that's where the party's at. And you'll find out if you do that. I'll find a place to stay. Get your booty on the beach shore. Swim right.
Today's mini segment comes from Peter Kane Dog Training. This guy is something special. He posts dog training videos, political vlogs, hunting-related videos, pigeon care videos, pigeon care videos, and even Sasquatch proof. Apparently, he has a real Sasquatch foot. But that is for another episode, another day. Let's talk dog talk.
The grossest thing a dog will do is eat poop. That's what I think. And they'll go for human poop, so watch out. If there's a bum around that's taking dumps on the sidewalk, a dog will go for it. That's a fact. Most dogs don't eat other dogs' poop, but some of them will. The more common thing is male dogs like Tonka will drink the pee of the female dog. It's disgusting. Tonka, I've seen him do it. You know, Ike, it's gross. Dogs will do disgusting stuff. And those are the most disgusting things that they'll do. They're disgusting, but awesome.
And we're back. Sondra Prill, my show, episode 3, the 5-year-long series finale and third episode. The episode consisted primarily of video footage from a party where she gave little thank you gifts to all the people that helped make her show possible. There was a 6-foot-long sandwich from Blimpy, and somebody got a $25 gift certificate for vitamins. And it aired for a year. And that's the book on Sondra and her show, my show. But Sondra did one more thing before giving up on her dream to become a pop sensation. Public access TV can only go so far. But in 1992, Sondra and her mother rented the 900-seat Tampa Bay Performing Arts Center Playhouse Theater, what a name, to present Sultry Sondra, a musical fantasy. The event really happened. It was real. This next excerpt comes directly from Daniel Ruth of the Tampa Tribune. Ticket prices for the show ranged up to $50, a testimony to a rather intriguing assessment of her talents, considering recent and slightly better known performers such as Al Green and Patti LaBelle charged a maximum ticket price of $25, half of that. That's a pretty good point. He goes on. Of course, Green and LaBelle lack Sultry Sondra's unique way of handling a melody, a cross between the dulcet sound of setting one's hair on fire and sticking one's hand into a garbage disposal. Imagine working for a newspaper and this is your assignment. Holy shit. He goes on. The show started 20 minutes late, and fortunately for the rest of the city, there weren't many of us in the audience. Only 41 tickets were sold. Of course, they did miss the dramatic moment during the performance where Sultry Sondra had honey poured all over her. Brinson M. Harris, a remote producer for the event, said a backup singer walked out from backstage to say goodnight and apologize to the audience. He also described the event as an hour and a half of Sondra Prill vaudeville and complete chaos. Holy shit, I would have killed to have been at this fucking concert. I was 8 at the time, but I still probably would have had a blast. I've always loved terrible shit like this. The show was apparently taped with plans for public access, but Sondra and her mom are believed to have destroyed the tapes before they made air. Fuck. I know this was a lot to digest, but it was all real. Very, very real. And for that, I am thankful. I plead with you. Look up and watch all of these Sondra Prill videos. Do it yesterday if you can. The mid-80s to early 90s were a golden age for public access television, and we are all lucky that some of that gold has been archived, digitized, and uploaded to YouTube, which is where I got all of this, therefore proving that the internet is a toilet. Make sure to check out the newly revised website, toilet.show, with links to socials, merch, and more. And while there, you can support the show and sign up for our Patreon. Get all sorts of bonus audio content for just $1 a month. Monthly bonus episodes, crossovers, and you even get these episodes early, if I finish them early. Otherwise, you can still catch them here Wednesday mornings, wherever they drop, wherever you're listening to them now, wherever. Please rate and review wherever you do such podcast things and get in touch. Tell me about some shitty shit on the internet that you know about that I may not. But until then,
bye, have a great time.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you today's Smule.com karaoke compilation. For more terrible karaoke, go to Smule.com. That's Smule, Smule.com.
Hello, friends. Wala kang bago gosi.
And everybody else.
Baby, when I met you, there was peace unknown.
I said how to get you with a pine tooth comb.
Oh, I was soaked inside. There was something going on.
You do something to me that I can't explain.
Hold me closer and I feel no pain. Every beat of my heart, we got something going on.
All this love we feel needs a conversation. We ride it together. Ha ha.
Making love with each other. Ha ha.
Islands in the stream. That is what we are. No one in between. How can we be wrong?
Sail away with me to another world. And we rely on each other.
From a lover to another, aha.
I can't live without you if the love was gone.
Everything is nothing if you got no one. And you didn't walk in the night, slowly losing sight of the real thing.
But that won't happen to us, and we got no doubt.
Too deep in love, we got nowhere out.
And the message is clear.
This could be the year for the real thing.
No more will you cry, baby, I will hurt you never.
We started in as one, in love forever.
We can ride it together. Uh-huh.
Making love with each other.
Uh-huh. I'll sing this dream. That is what we are.
No one in between. How can we be wrong?
Sail away with me to another world.
And we rely on each other.
Uh-huh. From one lover to another. Uh-huh.
Oh, sail away.
Sail away.
Ooh, come sail away with me.
Islands in the stream.
That is what we are.
No one in between.
How can we be wrong?
Sail away with me.
Ooh, another world.
From one lover to another.
Thank you for joining.
Welcome, God bless. Sit you talaga paos ng voices ko.
Thank you.
Welcome.
If there's a bum around that's taking dumps on the sidewalk, a dog will go for it. That's a fact.
That's true.